नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. सो मैच द फॉलोइंग, मैच द फॉलोइंग. सो मैप स्टडी, रिकनेंस, प्रिलिमिनरी, फाइनल लोकेशन सर्वे. सो व्हाट आर दिस? हाईवे अलाइनमेंट सर्वेस, हाईवे अलाइनमेंट सर्वेस. मैप स्टडी, रिकनेंस सर्वे, प्रिलिमिनरी सर्वे, फाइनल लोकेशन सर्वे. सो दीज आर द हाईवे अलाइनमेंट सर्वेस. एज ऑलरेडी वी डिस्कस्ड, मैप स्टडी इज डन इन ऑफिस. Map study is done in office if topographical map of that area is available. If topographical map of that area is available, then only we will able to do the map study. So map study is done in office. Reconnaissance survey. Reconnaissance survey is done by survey party at the field. Reconnaissance survey is done by survey party at site. Okay. So in survey party, in reconnaissance survey, survey party uses simple instruments like apne level, clinometer, barometer. So these are the different types of instruments. These are the different types of instruments used in survey party. So reconnaissance survey is done by survey party at site. So next, preliminary survey. In preliminary survey, what we will do? We will fix the best alignment. In preliminary survey, we will fix the best alignment among the like samples we will select. Okay, five alignments will be select. Among that, which is economical, we have to select the best alignment. And last is final location survey. In final location survey, we have to fix the alignment. Okay, so by using benchmarks, we have to fix the alignment. So next question. So instantaneous speed of vehicle at a specified section. Instantaneous speed of a vehicle at specified section. So it will comes under traffic volume studies. This topic and this question will come under traffic volume studies. So speed study, spot speed. Instantaneous speed of a vehicle at a specified section is known as spot speed. We have different types of speed, traffic volume study. In traffic volume study, different types of studies of traffic volume study, traffic flow characteristics, okay, spot speed study, speed and delay study, operational delay, fixed delay, accident study, parking study. So many of studies we have to study the traffic flow, how the traffic flow is going on at a particular section. So instantaneous speed of a vehicle at a specified section is known as spot speed. Next, so fixed delay and operation delay. Fixed delay and operational delay occurs at, fixed delay and operational delay occurs at, where fixed delay and operational delay occurs. What is fixed delay? Means fixed delay occurs at traffic signals. Means for 60 minutes, the signal will be red, you have to stop. That is fixed delay. Operational delay occurs due to movement of vehicles. Due to movement of vehicles, operation delays occurs. Fixed delays will occur at traffic signals. Fixed delay occurs at traffic signal. Fixed delay, traffic signal. Operational delay due to movement of vehicles. Movement of vehicles at junctions also, at junctions. So fixed delay and operation delay occurs at, first fixed delay occurs at traffic signals and operational delay occurs due to movement of vehicles at junctions. So next, match the following. So sign is given, symbol is given. So traffic, these are types of traffic signs: regulatory or mandatory, cautionary or warning, informatory signs. These are different types of signs. So for different types of sign conventions, we will use different symbols for representing traffic signals. So for regulatory or mandatory compulsory, you have to follow that sign. Regulatory or mandatory means compulsory. U-turn means U-turn, no U-turn means no U-turn, no right turn means no right turn. So like speed limit is 50 means speed limit is 50. So like that. So these regulatory signs are represented in circle. Regulatory sign or mandatory signs are represented in circle, except stop signal and give away. Those two will be represented in another shapes. Regulatory signs are mandatory signs. All are represented in circle except stop signal and give way signal. Next. So cautionary or warning sign, cautionary or warning signs are represented in triangle. Cautionary or warning signs represented in triangle. Informatory signs are represented in rectangle. So informatory signs represented in rectangle. This is warning sign. This is warning sign. Means suppose you are moving on a road, so you don't know whether you have to take left, right, or work is going on, work is in progress. So it will give warning. Work is going on, school ahead, college ahead, narrow bridge ahead, railway track ahead, petrol pump ahead. So like that it will give cautionary or warning signs. Informatory signs means it gives information related to when we are moving on a highway, we feel hungry, so we will see by the sides boards. Boards will be there on rectangle, restaurant ahead, 500 meters a toll head. If you go to left, you will go to Vijayawada highway. So like that they will, information will give, information, informatory signs gives about information represented in rectangle. Next question, 16th question, identify the following sign which are incorrect. Identify the following signs which are incorrect. So 50 speed limit will comes under mandatory sign, and mandatory signs or regulatory signs are represented in circle. Next, no sound horn will come under warning sign, but it is represented in triangle. No sound horn will come in warning sign, but it is represented, warning signs or cautionary signs or warning signs are represented in triangle. So this is incorrect. Mandatory sign, mandatory sign, the name itself here we can see and we can identify. Mandatory sign is represented in circle, but here we are representing the in triangle. So both B and C are incorrect. So shape of stop sign. So as when we are discussing class, so I said shape of stop sign is octagonal. So in the options, circle will be there, triangle will be there, rectangle will be there, but shape of stop sign is octagonal. Very important. So next, 18th question, which type of intersection is used where light traffic road crosses heavy traffic road? Which type of intersection is used where light traffic road crosses heavy traffic road? Road intersections: rotary, flyover, diamond intersection, delta interchange, cloverleaf interchange. So we have 5 types of interchanges, no? So rotary is nothing but roundabout. So we cannot use that rotary at where light traffic road crosses heavy traffic road. Okay. So next. So diamond interchange. Answer is diamond interchange is used where light traffic road crosses heavy traffic road. Which type of intersection is used where light traffic road crosses heavy traffic road means diamond interchange. Next, how many tons of roller is used in WPM road and how rolling is done? Waterpond Macadam road is identified by a Scottish scientist John L. Macadam, sorry, Scottish highway engineer John L. Macadam. So that's why we named it as WPM road, Waterpond Macadam road. So Waterpond Macadam road construction procedure, dust prevention, advantages, disadvantages, with different types of materials used, machinery used in WPM road. So we discussed so many of topics related to WPM roads. So here they are asking how many tons of roller is used in WPM road. Means this question is from construction steps of WPM road from rolling. So 6 to 10 ton 6 to 10 ton roller, 6 to 10 ton roller is used for rolling. And how rolling is done? Rolling is done from crown to edge, not from edge to crown. Rolling is done in WBM road. Rolling is done from crown to edge. Crown to edge, not from edge to crown. Okay. So how many tons of roller is used in WBM road? And how rolling is done? 6 to 10 ton roller, 6 to 10 ton roller is used in WBM road. And here rolling is done crown to edge. Rolling is done crown to edge. Next question. So 28th question. So example of rigid payment. Example of rigid payment. So we have two types of payment. One is flexible payment, another one is rigid payment. What is flexible payment? Means flexible payment has some elastic properties. Rigid payment does not have any elastic properties. Example of rigid payment, CC roads. Except CC road, all are flexible payments. Except CC road, all are flexible payments. So example of rigid payment is CC roads. Which type of winding material is used for WBM roads and size of screens for WBM roads? So which type of winding material is used for WBM road means in the construction steps of WBM road. So we discussed binding material. So the type of binding material is lime or kanker nodules. Lime or kanker nodules are used as binding material for WBM roads. Size of screens 10 mm to 12.5 mm. So what are screens? Screening is done for WBM road. Why we are doing screening means, so voids after compaction, some voids will be left between the particles. After compaction also, some air voids will be left between the particles. So those air voids are removed by application of screens. Whenever we are doing the compaction, so that after compaction, so what happens means, whatever the compaction is done, so between that compaction, some air bubbles will be there, some gaps will be there. So to fill that gaps, we are using screens of size 10 mm to 12.5 mm in case of WBM roads. Next, curbs and gutters are used in which type of pavement? Curbs and gutters are used in which type of pavement? So we discussed surface and subsurface drainage systems. Surface and subsurface drainage system. So curb and gutter are one of the method of surface drainage system. So curbs and gutters are used in which type of pavement? In street pavement for quick disposal. In street pavement for quick disposal, we will use curbs and gutters. Okay, curbs and gutters are used in which type of pavement? Street pavement. Intermediate. Okay, so next. So the first railway line. The first railway line 1853 was laid between Bombay and Thane at a distance of 33 kilometers. The first railway line was laid between in 1853 from Bombay to Thane at a distance of 33 kilometers. Next, coming to 24th question, match the following. So these are the different types of gauges. What is gauge? First of all, what is gauge? The distance between inner faces of rails. So these two are rails. So the distance between two inner faces of rails is known as gauge. So we have different types of gauges. So standard gauge, broad gauge, meter gauge, narrow gauge, light gauge also we have. So standard gauge means if the length of gauge is 1435 mm the length of gauge is 1435 mm, then we will say it as standard gauge. If the length of gauge is 1676 mm, then we will say it as broad gauge. If the length of gauge is 1000 mm, then we will say it as meter gauge. If the length of gauge is 710 mm, then we will say it as narrow gauge. So these are different types of gauges. There may be a chance of jumbling of questions. Okay, so flat foot rails is also known as, we have types of rails: double headed rails, bull headed rails, flat footed rails. 90% of railway tracks are laid with flat foot rails. In India, 90% of railway tracks are laid with flat foot rails. Who invented these flat foot rails? Charles Vignoles. Who invented these flat foot rails? Charles Vignoles invented these flat foot rails. So flat foot rails is also known as Vignoles rails. Flat foot rails is also known as Vignoles rails. So flat foot rails, 90% is used in Indian railway track, and these are invented by Charles Vignoles. So that's why we are calling it as flat foot rails is also known as Vignoles rails. Coming to last 26th question. So what is sleeper density? What is sleeper density? So what is sleeper density? Number of rails used per rail length. What is sleeper density? Number of rails used for rail length. What is sleeper density and its range? So number of sleepers used for rail length is known as sleeper density, and its range is n+3 to n+6 for main track. What is sleeper density? Number of sleepers used for rail length, and its range is n+3 to n+6. N is length of rail. Here n is nothing but length of rail. So depending upon the length of rail, we will decide n+3 to n+6 for main track. So these 26 questions are very important. So if you prepare for these 26 questions, maximum 90% of questions you will get from this. But don't forget about another questions. First prepare concept. This is last option. Most expected questions is the last option. So how today's children will be, means as are given 26 questions, so from that only questions will come. So don't think like that. Okay, don't think like that. And so please subscribe our video, like it. Okay, My Dream Academy is providing very good classes, most expected questions, previous year questions. So follow, like, share us. And so for each subject we are providing a most expected questions for each subject. So surely we will say that definitely from our most expected questions you will get at least you will get 4 marks. Subject is total 8 marks, no? At least you will get 4 marks. 4 marks is very even 1 mark is very important in competitive exams. As you know, after 2017, actually first 12 seats are there, now only 6 seats are there. So 1 mark is also very important to get an integrated rank. Okay, so thank you.